Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to Perpetus Vi on the PC. As usual, my name is Mike, otherwise known as the Gadget Addicts, and you'll notice the left-hand corner there, I'm cursed again. Yes, I tried to do the Crystal Caves and do the Seath fight, and the giant armor does not have any cursed resistance whatsoever. So I got myself cursed very quickly. So I done fucked up. And I have no purging stones, and I have nothing to trade for purging stones, so I figured I'm not going to go there. Instead, I'm going to go somewhere else where this curse will actually prove to be useful. Which is New Londo Ruins. So we need to go back to Filing Shrine for this one. See, there are enemies in New Londo, which are, well, for lack of a better term, the ghosts. And the only way to kill them is to have curse on your weapon or to be cursed. So rest there, get more Estus flasks. Now, from New Londo Ruins, you can actually get the cure to curse from Ingvard. Is it Ingvard? Something like that. So I'm going to head up there and see what chaos I can get myself into. There's also a Titanite slab up for grabs and clearing the route out to the Four Kings, which I can't do yet because I haven't beaten Sif. But I think pretty much what I'm going to be doing now, because the next few areas are actually ridiculously difficult for a myriad of different reasons. I'm going to get myself into good positions to start stomping some bosses, I think. And we're still going to go down the catacombs, and we're still going to do the DLC and stuff like that, so there's still plenty to be done in the game. Everyone says that when you get to past Ornstein someone that you're about halfway through the game, you're really not. There's so much still to be done. Right, we're going to see a former friendly face turn unfriendly here. In New Londo. Oh god, we're getting freezers. Not what I want. There we go, there's the crestfallen warrior. He's gone hollow. But he gets flattened quite nicely by this Vihander. Though he's a bit fast. A bit faster than I remember, certainly. And he's now gone. These hollows won't attack you. And you get 1,000 souls for his wretched ass. It's ridiculous. Got the S-Stock here, which is a really cool weapon. Obviously I can't use it. Because this is prepared to survive. There's any worthwhile items down here. Okay, now this is an area where the first time you ever come down here, it will fuck your shit up. Because it is singularly the creepiest and most overwhelming area in the game. Because of these ladies that we're about to encounter. And they're not particularly hard to fight. But they have some nasty attacks. You see, because I'm cursed, I can hit them. Naturally, the first time you come through here, if you're not cursed, hitting them, well, your sword just goes through them. And I will say, there are a lot of them. So you have to kind of take your time. So what we need to do is we need to clear out this water. Because kind of down there in that direction over that way is where we need to go for the Four Kings. Via the Dark Wraiths. Oh yeah, the Dark Wraiths are here. So we need to clear this whole area. Oh yeah, they can do that. You need to be on your toes with them. And they can also come to you from kind of any part of the map, really. Sometimes there is a way, I think you can get that one to come down to you. I think. Soundtrack doesn't help you. Yeah, this be a trap. Fuck you! Coming out of here is a great way to get overwhelmed. Because naturally you see that one at the end there and you just want to go and slash at it. Traption doesn't move. See? Alright, okay, okay. Camera fail, camera fail. Run away, run away, run away, run away. Remember, I'm cursed. I only got half health. Where are you off to? You on back in. I'm not sure what weapon they're using. It's some kind of dagger, I think. Either way, it goes through walls, and it's not nice when they can do that. Is that 2 foot? No. Alright, these nests. Oh yeah, it's also worth remembering there's no bonfire in this area. So the closest bonfire is Firelink Shrine. Which makes life infinitely more annoying. I'm just going to keep running around here. And they will come out the walls at me. Repeatedly, like I said, this place is just fucking creepy. This is a trap, I know. You can see them. Come on then. Here you go, love. Have a Zweihander to the face. Parrying dagger. A weapon I have no will, want, or desire to use, but I'll collect it anyway. Because loot. Where's Ray Parker Jr. when you need him? That's how these girls really do know how to make an entrance. And the good thing with this level, it is actually perfectly possible just to sprint it. Because the ghosts themselves aren't that fast. Yeah, that transient curse I picked up there, that's what you need to imbue your weapon with to be able to fight these things. Yeah, did I just miss a chest there? No, can't get to that yet. Right, okay, that's fine. Kick that, I don't know if that's shortcut 2. Doesn't actually seem to lead anywhere. Nope. Maybe it leads somewhere once I've drained the water off. I actually really can't remember. Unless it leads something down. Yep. There's another one there. What does it lead to? Sweet fuck all by the looks of it. Or does it just let me get rid of those two early? Really doesn't seem to lead to anything. No doubt there will be Sills veterans screaming at the screen right now, telling me what I've missed. Let's investigate. As best I can. No item there. Oh well. Maybe it'll become apparent once I've cleared the water out. Either way, we have a ladder there that does something. There's a ghost up there, she'll drop down when I come get the item. This is just a soul item. Come on, down you come. It's all I needed. I think a couple come up here. Oh, that's maybe the ones I've just killed. There's Ingvid up there, the weird creepy bastard himself. Okay. know if that attracts their attention or what. Yeah, it does. Whoa, shit. Okay, let's motor. Far more of them than I wanted to deal with. And let's just deal with them one at a time. Again, as you see, cursed. Not liking it. They're coming back up. They seem to be staying down in the water. I mean, to be honest, I'm fine with that if they want to stay down there. Shit. That actually did scare me. For fuck's sake, how am I going to deal with them if they're not going to come up here? Come on, ladies. Hmm, that's interesting. So they'll come up as long as I'm stood here, but no further. So what, have I got to let them get within attack range of me? So they're not actually going to come up and attack me properly, are they? How strange. Right, I'll tell you what, let's just run away from them. Right, hear about this room. Fuck me, this is hardcore. Whoa, what the hell's happening here? That a ghostly backstab. Shit, that's not good, not good, not good. Not good at all. Fuck me sideways. And get them into a line. Can deal with them, it's the group mentality that I don't like. And of course, as I say, I have such little health. And they can do that stretching out the arms thing, and that just really fucks me up. Hey, come on, any use coming this high up? Now, that's another two of them down. Isn't it a great farming location? It really, really is. Nice. How many have we got left? Oh, there we go. There's another two down. Good, keep moving. There's another one down. Alright, I'm going to see Ingvild up here. Shit the bed. Come on, nearly there, nearly there. I think they follow me up here. Do they? I thought I'd gotten them all.
Well, this is a surprise. I get few visitors, save for ghosts. You have the Lord Vessel. Very impressive. I know exactly what your intentions are. You seek the four kings whom I guard over. This is the key to the seal. The four kings slumber in the deepest chamber of the ruins. Use this key to break the seal and open the floodgates. Oh, and do not forget, the dark wraiths reside in a dark void called the Abyss. But the Abyss is no place for ordinary mortals. Although, long ago, the knight Artorias traversed the Abyss. If you can find him and learn from him, the Abyss may prove surmountable. Well, that can be quite such cleansing, but the breaking of curses is...
Okay, so I can have my curse broken. I need to give him humanity for it. He sells transient curses and resist curse. I'm going to buy a couple of them, because I will need them at some point. I'll leave him for now, so yeah, we can go to Ingvard to get cured of curse. But he's given us the key that lets us get rid of the flooding by when we go into that tower there. Alright, ghosties, ghosties, ghosties. There they are. Gotcha, bitches. And the key thing now is not to hang around. Right. Okay. Oh shit, it's freezing a lot. Fuck me, it does not like this level. Green Titanite. Okay, shit. Come on, so close. Right, there we go. Right, I need to get down to here. And pull lever. Nope. Key to the seal, there we go. And push the lever, and this opens up the back door to New Londo. And this, where the door opens, connects to the Valley of the Drakes, which then in turn connects to Darkroot Basin and to Blighttown and back to the other side of this. So yeah, it's all interconnected, it's all wonderful. But there we go, the water descends. Yeah, you can see the drakes and the Valley of the Drakes at the bottom there. And there'll be a dark wraith kicking around somewhere down there. Which is the thing I do not wish to fuck. Okay, now pull the lever. Now there is an item I believe I've missed. Right, how far up does that go actually? Yeah. There's a few items I've missed. One here. Combs a bow and large arrows. There you go, Valley of the Drakes down there. Why is it slowing down so much in this area? Must be the same thing that happened in Under Parish. Right, so still part... I want to head up here. I believe that item is useful to me. Shh, come on, come on, you can do it. Don't crap out on me yet, game. Humanity. Okay, I can break my curse. It's not what I thought it was. Why did I think that that was the ring that I wanted? That just drops me back into the room. This looks remarkably like the chapel thing at Firelink Shrine as well, incidentally. Is that it? Rare ring of sacrifice. Nope, it's still a good item to have. Fuck. Seriously, man, these ghosts do me fucking head in. They're one of those rare enemies in this game that employ full 3D movement. So you kind of have to be able to swing up and above to grab them like that. Okay. The annoying thing is, we're only about halfway through this level. Because we still have the whole section with the dark wraiths below to deal with. Although, to be fair, we can cheese about half of that. Missed an item. Basically, there is a curse bite ring in this level, and I don't, can't remember where it is, so I'm going to have to look that up. I wish it would stop freezing. If anyone has played this on the PC and has had these similar performance issues in this area, please do let me know what the fuck I can do about it. I'm using DSFix, I'm using everything I should be. I don't know why it's not working as it should. If actually, now that I've got the ghosties gone, I might as well go and... Actually, no, I can't. There is some ghosties I still need to deal with. I need to go back to the beginning of the level, if the game would fucking stop stuttering. It's weird. It seemed to be alright for the first half of the level, and then I get to here, and it's all gone tits up. Okay, it's out here. That's what I wanted. Ooh! Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. Fuck off. Okay, so now I have the curse bite rings. So that combined with Havel's armor should make life easier for dealing with Seath when I go back to him. That's what I was trying to get. See, there is some method to the madness. It's all about just kind of, you know, rattling your way through it again and again and again until you work out what works. Okay. We still need to go back to the beginning of the level, because there is something I have missed, and I do know that for sure. So I'm just going to run back quickly. Because there is a Firekeeper soul here. Now, you notice I only have Estus Flask plus one, and I have had that since the beginning of the game. Because the second Firekeeper soul that you find is the one I gave back to Anastasia. Anastasia? Either way, to get the... to get the bonfire back. That's it, to get the bonfire back in Firelink Shrine. That was the whole point of that. So while I'm cursed, I might as well get the second one, which is over here at the beginning of the level. And you go down the stairs, that's it. Right, so we come down here. Weird blue flame there. You wouldn't have seen all this before, because it was underwater. But we're going to get some ghosty ladies here. You can see them hanging around down there. It's a horrible trick when you haven't cleared the water out. Jesus Christ, that was very, very close. I think there's still probably another one to come. Now, the Firekeeper soul. Yeah, so you haven't cleaned out the water, you can't really see this platform, so you'll jump and you'll fall, and you'll die, and you'll hate yourself. Okay, so that's all the ghosties dealt with. Could go up to Ingvid, because to be honest, I don't really have that many souls. And I can skip about half this level with a shortcut. Anyway, when it comes to fighting the four kings. Let's go back up to Ingvid, we'll get cured of curse. And then we'll start to do the Dark Wraiths bit. I don't think I'll succeed in it, but we can certainly try it. We get some rather interesting enemies coming up. The Dark Wraiths themselves have been in this one and Dark Souls 3, and they're a fucking nightmare. Actually, well, they're varied. Sometimes they're a nightmare, sometimes they're really, really easy. Depending on how good you are at parrying, they're obscenely easy to parry. But if they connect, they do a lot of damage, which is why I want to get my curse lifted first. And I went the wrong way there. I wanted to go up the fireplace. Yeah, that's why I want to get my curse lifted first, so at least then I've got some decent HP. But however, the giant's armor should being in quotation marks, I should have enough poise that even if they hit me, I'll be able to hit back. We'll try it. Like I say, I don't have that many souls, so I'm not really that arsed about dying, but I want to get the curse lifted first.
You broke. No, I have no regrets, but you can proceed.
Someone. Right, ooh, have curse broken. Alright, I need to use the humanity. I thought you couldn't use it when you were cursed.
Ooh.
There we go. Now if I run into a ghost, I can't really attack it without using a transient curse, which I do have 5 of. But I'm pretty sure I've got them all. I shouldn't need to worry about them unduly. Right, so let's head down that lift that I conjured up and see where it takes me. This particular bit of the level I get a little bit fuzzy on. Can't really remember it that well. Because, like I say, normally I tend to skip most of New Londo. I tend to get rid of the water and then do the halfway thing. No, wrong way. Went the wrong way again. Do the halfway thing. Yeah, I clear out the water and then I do the shortcut, which takes you kind of right up to near the end. So I'm fairly sure that I'm going to die here, but I don't mind. I've died enough in this series so far. I'm really not going to complain too much if I do get killed here repeatedly, obscenely. And I have enough souls that I'll be able to level up. Still quite nervous first time you take on a Dark Wraith. There, you can see he's up there in the blue. And they've got this weird kind of force shield thing, which if you join the Dark Wraith Covenant, you can get. Good for farming, 1,200 souls apiece. I'm not going to complain about that. I'm not bothering with the drakes. They can go fuck. They can go fuck, they can go get fucked. Sorry, I'm really tired today. I can't seem to speak. Nice. Where's the next Dark Wraith come from? I think he's at the end of this. There he is. Oh yeah, I've got plenty of poise here. Oh yeah, he's got soul drain as well. Which is not nice if you get caught by it. That's a little proud knight. Possibly do a find some humanity at some point. To be honest, I think this is where I'm going to die. In here. Because there's quite a few Dark Wraiths in here, and some kind of weird ass magical creature that is not nice to fight. At least not when you're being attacked by several Dark Wraiths. Ooh, 309, not bad. Gets him down. Yeah, that thing. There's two of those in this level, and they don't respawn, which is nice. And again. But I can't really remember how to fight them. Those things explode, I believe. Yeah, they do. Okay, so... Ah, and he spits them out. Okay, so we're just going to take it nice and slowly. Ah, I didn't want to do that. And again, and one more hit when my stamina regenerates. Should do it. Like I said, this thing won't respawn. Which is nice of him. Gives you a lot of souls, actually. Is there any more dark wraiths in here? I have a feeling that I'm missing something. And I don't know why that is. Part of me thinks that there's another dark wraith in here. Something, I heard something walking. There he is! Okay, that was stupid. And he's down. Okay, I can't remember how to get those items either. Left or right? I don't think it makes much of a difference. Is that a shortcut? It is, back up to here. Cool. Didn't even know that existed. I still have to deal with loads of ghosties first, though. Alright, item here. Humanity. Okay. So where does this lead us? Alright, that item there that I didn't know how to get. So would that mean it probably also leads us to the treasure chest on the other side? See, every day's a school day, you learn something new. And here. Wow, this is a long way around. Where the hell's it taking me? It is taking me to the treasure chest. I had a worrying feeling there that it was... Oh, it's a very large ember. That's what I need. Mint. That's how I get my, Zvaya Hander above plus 10. I had a really worrying thought there that might have been a mimic. I really did not want it to be a mimic. Alright, okay. So, we... Just carrying on down. I don't have any Estus left, so I'm kind of relying on not fucking up. Which of course means I'm going to fuck up. And the worst part is there's no quick way back to a bonfire. So I don't believe I've got any homeward bones. I do not know, so whichever way I go, I'm going to have to run back. Pardon me is tempted to put on the rare ring of sacrifice, but then if I do die, it seems like a waste of a ring of sacrifice. Wouldn't you agree? But this is the shortcut down here, so you see where that sign is up there? That leads back to... That leads from the bonfire. So in future, I'll just be running down here if I die. Well, when I die to the Four Kings. Staggered. Deaded. So we're nearly at the end. Castle of Proud Knights. Okay, so we have another couple of Dark Wraiths, and yes, I know I've passed one. But this is the one I want to deal with first. Come on. Yes, use your Dark Hand all that you want, but it's not going to save you. Fuck you. I'm going to steal my soul. Zuh. Ooh, crack red eye orbs. You can use them for some purging stones later. Don't think there's anything else down here. Certainly don't think there's any more dark wraiths in this direction. Oh, we can hear another one of the squishy things. Yes, that's that one done. Right, there's one through here. We undo the hidden wall. I don't like fighting that one on there. Simply enough, it's far too easy to fall off. If we just take our time with this guy, everything should come up golden. You, some soft humanity would not go down amiss. Would not go amiss, rather. Okay, not a mimic. Titanite chunk. Excellent. Which I'll need for ascending my Zweihander even higher. Oh god, the stuttering. A silver proud knight. Ah, shit. Let myself get hit. Come on. Hit him. Oh, the stutter. What the fuck's going on here? Right. Use humanity. Full health. I do think there's a second Dark Wraith in here, though. Yeah, there is. Sometimes I really wish there was friendly fire on in this game. Oh, I'm gonna hit each other. No, managed to stagger him. Goddamn low wall. This one's perpetually being a dick. You gonna drop me anything? Nope. Okay, so just the squishy and one more Dark Wraith to deal with, and then clear the area. And you keep an eye out for the exploding skull. Yeah, it's range. I stay close enough and he won't summon any more skulls. This thing always reminds me of a very large version of Phalanx from Demon Souls. Especially the little hoplite things that he has coming off his body. And there we go, he's down. Chest in here, I believe. Not a mimic. Titanite chunk. Is there another chest? Something in my head said there was two chests in here. Nope, okay. Ragdoll physics for the win, and the last Dark Wraith is here. when things get a bit stuttery again. Oh, Nelly died. Gotcha, bitch. Santa head. Okay. Oh no, that's where Witch Beatrice's summon sign appears. So that is the Four Kings boss fight down there, but I can't go there because I don't have the Seal of Artorias, which means I can't get the... Basically, I can't traverse the Abyss. If I go into there, I'll fall into the Abyss and I'll die, and I'll not come back. And it will be unpleasant, and people will cry, and everyone will declare that it was a really bad idea for me to go down there. Which, to be fair, they would be right. So we're going to head back up to Firelink Shrine now, because that's pretty much New London Ruins done, apart from the Four Kings. So, yeah. I think I was actually pretty successful managing that without dying. I'm actually rather happy with myself. Although, to be fair, it's come very close. I've got that much health left and no Estus. My voice is starting to go. Lying in ambush. I must have suddenly gotten connected to the network. I'm suddenly getting phantoms appearing and messages on the ground. Oh shit, Nelly fell down. So yes, so if we come down here, you'll see the route that I'll take. So when I come back to do the Four Kings, sprint down here past the ghosts, and then just a roll over there, and I can head down towards the Four King boss fight. Which is kind of, it's small mercies kind of thing, because if it wasn't for that, it would be such a long way for an area without a bonfire. The closest two bonfires to this area are Blight Town and Firelink Shrine. Which says a lot, really. Really it does. But I think I've done quite well. I've managed to survive it. I haven't died. I've got 28,000 souls to spend. And I've got a Firekeeper soul. Which means I'll get more bang for my buck with each Estus. As you can see, I'm rather fond of the Estus. So let's head back up. Up here. Alright, we'll go speak to Anastasia. And then we'll go level up and I'll call that a day. So I think probably next time will be the catacombs, maybe. Maybe do pinwheels and get 15 Estus. Game would fucking stop stuttering. For the very least, I am not cursed anymore. Which is a big weight off my shoulder. I hate being cursed. Having half health throughout it just really, really drives you nuts. Right, okay, let's speak to Anastasia. Okay, Estus Flask plus 2. I can't remember where the other Firekeeper souls are. There's one in Blight Town, and which I haven't bothered to get, and there's one somewhere else. Right, level up. Let's do... and get one level, so let's... carry on... no, I'll do more Vitality, more HP. Right, so I'm going to leave it there for now. If you enjoyed this, please do leave a like and subscribe, and come back next time for more Prepare to Survive. And I thank you for watching, and good night.